The following program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.
Hi, this is Ken Gidson. This is the Art of Politics, and look at my shirt. This is a very artistic shirt. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, this is one great, great, honest to God, good, God-fearing Democrat, and over on this side is an awful Republican.
How are you, Ken?
How are you?
Been a while, yeah.
Yes, it has. Yeah,
This is the fact. Fiction, but go ahead.
You know, how are you?
I'm doing great.
Because we had a lot to talk about. Trump, we agreed that we would talk about what's taking place in around this part of the world.
Right. Yeah, because we don't want to talk about the criminals and other stuff.
That's
here,
we certainly on the Democrat side, the ones who believe
the emails, Benghazi,
it's better than
go on and
in
on.
Russia, and of course the taxes that are not. Yeah. All right. Howie, you're campaigning, is that correct?
I am. I have a primary Tuesday. Is 10 people, I think it is, running for 7 seats.
Okay.
And it's going to be fun. I always have a primary every 2 years. I'm attacked by the Democrats, phone calls, robocalls.
Well, this time you really have done some pretty dumb things.
Well, that's in your mind.
Anything, you know, a lot of people.
Anything that deals with First Amendment naturally is dumb to you guys.
Right.
When somebody speaks the facts, you guys don't like it.
Okay, less. We can get to that, but let us, you got a primary, and you're usually a top vote getter anyway,
right.
Is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
But you're a little, because of the, you got some negative publicity, is that bother you a little?
No, not at all. I get negative all the time because I
not
speak
like
my
this.
Mind.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Not
I,
like this.
I went
international.
Yeah,
bad.
I went international years ago, a few years ago when I led the charge on a piece of legislation.
Of what?
On some of the things when I said we were selling kids, the state of New Hampshire.
Selling kids.
Kids. But Title 4D money.
Gentlemen, I have a feeling this is going to be a great show. Selling kids already, and we're not even five
no,
minutes into the
because
show.
Because what I said was, just so you know, is at the time I was asked a question in hearing, and I said the state of New Hampshire is selling children because we had grandparents at the time in the court system fighting for their grandchildren, okay, to take custody because their kids had issues, you know, to take over
so
parental rights.
So what's the selling kids?
Let me finish. But anyways, under Title IV, federal money, okay, $10,000 comes into the state of New Hampshire for administrative costs for the courts to help offset the cost to adopt children outside the family.
Okay.
So in order to bring attention on this here, you're taking children from homes that are having problems, or dysfunctional homes, and the law says you can put them in boyfriend-girlfriend homosexual or single person, they're not married, they're not stable families. So you're gonna adopt children into families that are playing house and are not stable.
Okay, so what you're saying is that wherever the kids are and they don't have anything, and of course these, as one would say, these people were vetted, meaning that they were considered
no,
by
they didn't have
the courts of the
words,
good.
You're putting
so
words in my mouth.
So what you're saying
you just put
is
words.
You
no.
want the
no.
children to do what?
No. You just put words
because
in my mouth.
Because they're homosexual,
no,
they shouldn't
no,
be put into that
no,
family?
No, had nothing to do.
You did it, too.
No, I
you
said
did so homosexual.
I said boyfriend, girlfriend, single parents.
And homosexuals.
Okay, and homosexual all couples. Right. That's the law. Okay, what don't you understand about the law in New Hampshire? So now, if you're not married...
Excuse me, you said that negatively.
No, I didn't.
You didn't?
No, you took it that way.
So what's the selling of kids? That's your typical BS. Get to the point.
What I'm saying is the grandparents should be working with the Health and Human Services to take custody of the children. Instead, if they adopt them outside the family, they will get Title IV money, the state, the court system, $10,000. You would know because you're not involved in the family courts like I am.
So,
am I confusing you?
You know
am
something.
Am I confusing you on kids with problems?
No, you're not.
Adopting them outside the family?
No, but you're saying that the grandparents should do that.
I'm saying the grandparents, there's a site in here in New Hampshire a few years back, we did redress of grievances hearings.
I know that.
There was grandparents that came in that wanted custody of their grandchildren, but they wouldn't turn them over to the children. They said, well, you don't make enough. You don't make this. Or you're a military guy. Or you're in and out of the VA. You got medical issues. You can't adopt your grandchildren. That's BS. They have no criminal records, no nothing.
You know,
and the children were adopted outside.
And I remember what was it called, this little court? I know Senator Avard was on.
It was a redress of grievance in accordance with the Constitution.
And it was so interesting that you happened to bring this up. And there are people, some of them have legitimate agreements, and some of them don't. This just may not be legitimate.
Why not?
Simply because there's a
Tell
good possibility that the courts are not stupid.
Okay.
But you'd like to think they're stupid.
No, I never said they were stupid.
So
what they do is they listen to Health and Human Services on making the decisions. And then the almighty dollar within the family courts. Do some searches on the issues within the courts.
Excuse me, so they're selling kids.
Can you have, no.
You just said they were selling kids.
What I did was I used that word to gain attention on the grandparents that are being pushed aside and the children being adopted outside the family.
So they were... you just said selling kids.
But, Ken, I'm tired of repeating myself.
But who got the $10,000?
The court system from the federal government. What don't you understand? I got to keep repeating myself.
Is that just for every kid they get $10,000?
For every child that they adopt, they get money which is called Title IV-D money from the federal government.
So you think that the courts do this just to get the money?
I'm thinking the almighty dollar.
Oh, my God.
Yes,
I'm thinking,
why would you not work with the grandparents? Why would you not work with the parents to try to make them better parents and educate them?
Why would you not try to get them in drug programs? When it usually gets to the point where they're taking the kids away
from
the parents.
How much have you been involved in this?
Are you under the impression, trying to explain to our listeners that if the court takes the children away from the parents, are you telling me the court's just doing this?
I'm saying Health and
Human Services. These are all good parents.
If you follow the money trail in the Health and Human Services and the family courts and the foster parents, because there's a lot of problems within the foster parent stuff that's going on with children. Just look what's going on around the country. Okay,
I know people in foster care, and I really wish you wouldn't. I really wish you wouldn't say that because, there is problems.
Not all, Ken.
But
you're a typical
if you have
Democrat.
One out of 100,000, to you, it's all foster parents.
No, nobody's saying
foster
that.
Foster parents are very important.
Ken, I'm not going to sit here and let you throw words in my mouth. That's a bunch of BS. Okay?
Did you expect anything different?
I understand that. We have issues within the family courts. We should be, as legislators, trying to get Health and Human Services to work with the families. If there's drug problems with the family, get them help versus adopting the children outside.
I'll tell you what. I'll trust the courts if they take the children completely away. I do, because many times these kids are traumatized anyway.
So you
really want to put them back into those situations.
So you put them in homes and you adopt them outside their blood, okay, to other families when... If a grandparent wants to adopt their children, work with that grandparent.
Well, I happen to agree with
you. I can tell
you
right now.
Why wouldn't they do it?
I'm going to give you a case
they do it?
I'm going to give you a case right now where I had to call the director and the commission on. Okay, I'm heavy involved in this stuff in the children. You have no clue what you're talking about. You're throwing out stuff.
I do.
Ken, I've never seen you sit in the court.
Yes, Al, I do.
Ken, I've never seen you sit in the court with some of us other legislators.
Okay.
I've never seen you over at the daycare where families got to turn over their children in Nashua or in Manchester or in other areas of the state.
Turn over their children for what?
Because you have to, where police, you know, they have to have, like, supervised visits.
Supervision.
Right. And I've
the
gone
fathers
in.
And there's some of us legislators.
There's some of us legislators that are involved in this stuff. And we go there and observe
you,
and see what's going on.
Are you a person that looks?
To see what's going on, yeah.
To watch what's going on.
To watch what's going on. So
okay,
to see whether our laws are working or not.
I happen to agree with you. If the parents, if the grandparents are in good health,
right,
fairly good health, and they can help the child, mm-hmm, all right? Because you got to have something. You have
right
to have something stable for the kid, all right? Then I happen to agree with you. But I just don't believe, like you,
okay,
that all the courts make all these awful, awful mistakes.
In Franklin Court, a military guy had to come home from overseas because the courts made a stupid decision, went against the Soldiers and Sailors Act, the judge over there, and took the child from the mother and father who had custody of the child, I mean the grandparents, that had custody of the child, while the veteran who had custody of the child was serving overseas. The mother of the child went into court and gave, you know, whatever, when they should have never done that because of the Soldiers and Sailors Act. So I went in with some lawyers,
yeah,
and we got the child back.
You
the veteran
the
had
back
to leave, come back from Afghanistan, to come back and get the child. Now,
well, Al,
when a child
that's
is,
your job.
No, they're not even, these aren't even my
that's
district.
That's your job.
They're not even my district. I'm a family advocate for children.
Excuse me.
Okay?
You're also
I'm an
a
advocate.
Veteran.
Right, I understand. Okay, I'll give you another case. Another in Laconia. The family, a grandfather, he's retired in the military, disabled veteran, him and his wife. No criminal, nothing. He gets retirement there, plus his disability or Social Security. You know, the Health and Human Services says you don't make enough money to adopt your grandchildren. The parents of the children are in jail, both of them, okay? The grandparents have no nothing.
They're a criminal, in jail.
Criminal, the parents are.
Parents are.
Right, but the grandparents, who's a retired military, who's a disabled vet, who can move around, he's in a
how
wheelchair.
How many children are there?
There's two children. Now.
How old are they?
I had to get involved,
I
think 8 and 10.
Okay.
I got involved and went to the commissioner and got people's eyes in this and supervisors'
yeah, go
eyes
ahead
in this.
Yeah.
Because the person below was making decisions and telling the courts, well, they're unfit for parents. Without nothing.
So
without
did
no
you
proof,
help them?
I did help them.
And did they get the kids?
But yes, they did. But what I'm saying is,
did they adopt the kids?
They got custody over the kids.
Not adoption.
Not adoption, because they're hoping that when the parents get out of jail, that they can work with them to make them better parents.
What are they going to jail for? Do you know?
I don't know. I'm not aware. I'll talk about it.
Okay.
But anyways, the system should be trying to work with these parents to make them better parents.
So you don't. If they got you don't think they do that?
No, I don't. I don't. And I'll tell you why. Okay,
I believe they do that.
We're dumping thousands and thousands of dollars into Health and Human Services. Some of them do a great job, but we got a small percentage that follow the money, that follow the dollar.
Yeah, and I'm going to tell you a story about following the
okay,
money.
Okay, they follow
spent
the money. Some of them, they do a great job because I've met some great people who work for Health and Human Services.
Yeah.
But I met some that hate fathers, that don't want fathers involved. They'd rather push them out because there's more money involved. The more
will
their cases involved.
Stop saying money.
I'm telling you
are
the truth.
Are you telling me that
is
there
it,
are people
you can't handle the facts
who use money instead of the children?
Yes, yes.
I don't
I've been in the
you
court
I'm
systems.
Sorry. I don't believe you.
I watched in Derry Court. I watched a judge
so,
who we try to
but
impeach.
What you're saying
listen
is they sell kids.
No, I'm saying you know
they get $10,000.
No.
I'm sorry. I don't
adoption
want to. All right.
Adoption.
Adoption.
Okay.
Okay? Right.
Adoption.
Yeah. Adoption. All right.
And since the federal money came in with their laws from the federal government on the Title IV money, the court system's broken. The court system's all about the almighty dollar. You have what happens when the court? Why the court wants you to pay the court? What happens? Since you know it all about this.
If the court wants
in
you to pay
child
the
support, when the courts make a family, instead of paying directly to the mother, when the courts make the family pay the child support to the court, what happens to the court? Do the law.
Don't they give it the money to the...
Yeah.
Okay.
But what's the benefit? Why is the court involved in that?
Well, I think that's... I don't think that's a difficult one. Is because they want to make sure that the kids get the money.
Is that what it is?
And I'm positive.
And you got good parents that have been paying and willing to that's not the truth.
The fact is,
here we go again. Have you been into the courts?
No,
you're telling me it's not the truth. I'm a liar.
I'm not going to accept this.
I'm not going to accept this.
But are you saying this happens to all parents?
No, let me educate you why.
Wait a minute. Are you saying it happens to all parents?
I'm saying this happens to 65, 70%. Now, I'm going to tell you why. Okay? You don't even know why.
65 and 70%?
You don't know why.
All right, why?
Okay, now. Under Title 4D money, the more money that the courts collect, they get administrative costs from the federal government. So the more money that they accumulate, that they're accepting, that they're collecting from child support that comes into the courts, the federal government kicks in money.
You know,
do you
see the money trail? You don't know. I love you, but the problem here is that you
Ken, are you calling me a liar?
Hate government.
Are you calling me a liar?
No, I'm not calling you a liar.
Are you saying what I'm saying is wrong?
No, I'm just saying I don't think the people who are watching this are getting the entire story.
Yeah, they are.
What you're saying to
what
me,
I'm
listen,
saying
I
government
heard,
got involved.
Can I finish? Jeez, you talk.
You want government
involved. I'm not letting you, last week I let you do this, I'm not letting you do this.
Okay, go ahead.
All right, okay?
All right, talk. But don't throw no BS. Okay, I want facts.
That's what the show is about.
No, it's not about the BS.
Yes, it is.
But we want people.
It has to be.
It can't be. It got to be about
Why
facts.
Why would they watch this show if
it's got to be about facts, okay?
Wait a minute. Facts has nothing to do with political
stuff.
Yes, it does. Oh, absolutely.
Well, if I brought up the laws of what's going on in New Hampshire, you don't have a clue.
That's right. I don't. I don't have a clue.
You don't.
All
I've
right.
never seen you in the courts on any family.
All right, now, okay, stop. I know, for instance, I've heard where mothers, well, in this case, it's been mothers. I'm sure it's been fathers. Mothers have not received the monies that were supposed to be paid weekly or monthly.
Right.
You know.
Then they go to welfare and then to the courts.
So they grab the father and say,
"Who's they? Who's they?"
Meaning the court system.
Okay. How does the courts get involved?
Well, the court because
on money that's owed. Do you even know the system that's in place for that?
Yeah. Actually,
tell me.
They usually go through a lawyer.
Yeah.
And the lawyer says...
Okay, you don't have the money for a lawyer. What do you do? What's the system in New Hampshire? If you don't have money for a lawyer, which many of them don't, low income, what's the...
I don't have the proper
Because you don't know.
For, no, yes, I do.
Okay,
no,
well,
no,
what
that,
is it?
That's not fair.
Okay, no, okay,
all
then
right,
tell
okay.
me. Tell me what it is then. I'm waiting. Since you know it all.
So am I supposed to name the
yeah.
exact...
Yeah, what the procedures
no, but
are.
I
so you can tell your constituents.
No, I just think I've given enough of... I mean, I don't know the names. I don't know where it is. I don't know the place. But I do know why the money is taken and given to the courts, and the courts do pay the mother or the father. Yes, I do. But I just don't happen to know. Huh?
But they're forcing people to pay in cases where the parents... Of you know, we're paying directly to the parent. They're
Why?
Making the payment. What don't you understand? What I just explained to you. I got. Are you slow today?
Oh, God.
Are you understanding? Do you understand federal
law?
This
is going to be a law? Great day. This we haven't even started.
You
we haven't even gone out of
no,
local
No, you
want
to talk
stuff.
About New Hampshire?
No, you
I brought some. I brought something
show,
up.
Show those people your new watch.
Huh?
You can hang that on
See,
a
you're
wall.
Changing, you're changing the subject. You're
you know,
great
that,
at it.
That's exactly
you're changing
correct.
The subject.
All right.
That's
okay.
Right.
All right.
Okay. I'm going to explain the situation for low-income and people that are tied up in the courts.
Can you please move on?
I just want to explain to the people here. We have within Health and Human Services a department there, on which is called for to get reimbursements of monies owed and child support. They will go into the courts for you if you can't afford a lawyer, okay? I just worked a case a while ago here in Nashua, okay, on a young mother there who the father wasn't paying and all that. And then we got him in the right department in Nashua, through the Health and Human Services, where they go into court, they go after them, and then they go after the taxes for back support. Okay?
Okay.
I've been, what I'm trying to tell you is,
so,
I've been working this stuff for
no,
the last
I,
10
years. No, I got
years.
That, but now, but you're saying...
But what I'm saying is, that here is a good case here on somebody
That's
not
a good
paying.
Case.
That's
a good
case. But there are other cases where the courts will demand you pay the courts because the more money they get into the system,
they get paid.
The more they get paid to
All right, okay.
Costs.
That's one story, but I want to tell because I have talked about this before. I just want to talk about it again. 4 years ago, and I was in the Hillsborough County Commission. I was one of the commissioners for 2 years. What a mistake that was! I'll never do that again. And what it is that we have a budget, Hillsborough, that's like, I think it's 80-something million dollars. And in Hillsborough, like all the other counties, you pay for your jails, you pay. It's just like two governments, government within a government.
Right.
So we had 4.5 social workers for.
I think this is important because we had
this adds something else to it. We had 4.5 social workers who came in and said, look, our budget is $465,000. We saved the state of New Hampshire $1.5 million. We have the proof. In comes a judge and sits down and says, you know, you got to keep these social workers because by keeping these social workers, not only you save the money, but they can get the people off the drugs and get them in the programs or what they need, and I don't have to put them in jail. The police say, well, guess what? I go over to arrest these people, and they're not really bad enough to put in jail, but you have to because there's nothing else to do. So they need the social workers. Everybody agrees they need the social workers. The most important part is it saves $1.5 million. And guess what happened, ladies and gentlemen? They took that $465,000, right, and said, we're going to save the taxpayers' money, and they got rid of the social workers.
Well,
now let me finish,
okay?
Because this is the point.
Because you're not being truthful.
No, well, no, that happens to be true.
It did happen.
Okay,
But tell them why.
But let me
tell them why.
No, wait a minute.
Why they
so
cut that?
So let me tell you.
Tell them about the duplication.
Ladies and gentlemen, listen to this. Are you ready? If we would have had those social workers, they're the first people who would have noticed, would have brought to our attention, would have done everything as soon as the drugs hit. Why I'm bringing this up again is the last meeting we had at Hillsborough County, they wanted $400,000, not for social workers, but for drug treatments.
No drug court.
No, it wasn't social workers.
It was drug court.
No, it was not.
Yeah, you guys.
No. Right. You're not
you guys,
at Hillsborough County.
Hillsborough refused you're to go to drug Hillsborough. Court, and they wanted the state to pay it. In my county, we pay for a drug court. Okay, the county pays.
Just we've had, you know.
No, you didn't. You went to the state house. It was legislation there wanted the state
me,
to pay
Nashua
for it.
Nashua has had these courts for years.
You have a drug court in Nashua.
Yes.
Or do you have
a long time?
Or do you have regular courts in Nashua?
No, we have a drug court in Nashua.
You're positive on that.
Am I positive? Yes, very positive. It's been several years.
Courts.
Oh, for God's sakes.
National.
All right, so there we go. Ladies and gentlemen,
New Hampshire.
And these people can get reelected because they say they save you all the money. But, you know, when the social workers are out there and they see the drugs starting to come, right, they're the ones on the front line. They can grab the situation and come to us or the police or whatever it is. But people died because of $465,000, because they saved the state $1.5 million. That's stupid.
See, I'm not in Hillsborough County, and I can't speak to that. But what I do think is, and as a conservative, thinking in the mentality why they did it from what I heard, because there was duplication of...
There was no duplication.
Because the state already is already paying.
There was no duplication.
So you're telling me the state in Nashua...
There was no
You have a welfare department and health and human services here in Nashua.
You know something, Al?
Are you telling me
they're something, Al?
You're telling me they're not paying?
I took this thing very, very serious.
Because you didn't
know
about
it. You know what? I don't know why. Because they were saving the taxpayers' money, keeping people out of jail, which we pay for that in Hillsborough County, all right? Keeping people out of jail is really important because it saves us a lot of money. Mm-hmm. Getting people into drug programs, that's really, really important. Mm-hmm. Taking kids, splitting sometimes mm-hmm. parents apart because they're going to kill each other. Yet, guess what? Let's save $465,000. And 1.5, hey, that
now,
means nothing.
What I'd like to bring something up here. I stand corrected here because I just passed some bad information here, which I apologize for, because my understanding, I never knew Nashua did have, they started in July of 2014. They did a pilot program in 2014. I didn't realize that they did that.
You're talking about the drugs.
This is why I believe in
You're
trust but verify. Yeah, on the drug courts.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Is that what you were doing?
That was what I was doing, because I'm a true believer in trust and verify.
Oh, for God's
Because my
sakes.
Understanding a few years ago, you
well,
be, did Nashua.
Let me ask you a question.
Hillsborough County
I
was trying to
fight
it. I live
here in Nashua. People in Nashua, don't you think they would call my house and yell and scream that it wasn't true?
If Ken Gidge was truthful all the time, I would not have to trust but verify.
All right.
Okay, so I said, you notice how vulnerable I am? I stood corrected, and I apologize. You were
You were dumber than a rock when it came to this situation.
Not dumber for a
and
rock.
Because
it's just
you,
that because
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, that saves a lot of money, but it was the Republicans who wouldn't put the money into these courts. But it was Nashua who was one of the first in the state, but they wouldn't put it in because guess what? They didn't think it worked.
Okay.
Even though there was, guess what? Even though there was proof and it saved you money, Republicans. All right, let's do something local.
The Republicans put in the drug court. So just so you know, the police, half the stuff that comes out of his mouth, I don't know what the
police. Yeah, all right, okay.
All right, go ahead.
All right, locally. So you're going, let's stay over. You're Londonderry area, correct?
Mm-hmm, right.
All right, so there is 7 seats, 10 people.
10 people running.
So in other words, if you get a seat, you run. This is your
more than likely, yeah. We're a very strong conservative. In my district, in London.
No, are you talking Republicans now?
Republicans, right. But there's 7, Democrats, of course, will probably run. And they always lose. I think they have had two Democrats that have won in 100 years or something like that in my district.
No, I'm missing a point.
No.
Are there 7 seats?
In my district, yes.
So you have 7 representatives?
7 representatives.
All right. Are there Republicans, Democrats?
No, we're all Republicans that are legislators there.
Okay, so really, when you say there are 7 seats, and you say you have a primary.
Right, meaning there's 10 people running for 7
seats.
Right,
so you really have won.
No, I haven't.
You'll win one of the 7 seats.
Possible, yeah.
Okay, so.
I always come out number one.
Okay, so that means you've basically won the election. You don't have to.
No. Well, I mean, unless, more Democrats moved into my town, then it's different.
Okay, so
For all practical purposes.
All right, okay, so you win the one of the 7 seats. You win. You don't have to. You don't have to. Your election's over.
I don't get too cocky because.
What do you mean two? What are you talking about? If you win one of the 7, you've won.
No, because there's still I'm running against 7 in the general election. 7 Democrats.
Oh, you didn't say that.
Yeah, don't you? How long have you been a legislator, knowing that September 13th?
Well,
the
I was
primary.
Trying to get it out of you. I didn't
why?
Understand.
What didn't you? You didn't understand
you didn't,
what I said in the primary? 10 running for 7 seats?
No. I didn't. No, you Republicans have. Okay.
Right, we have a primary.
Are they after you?
Oh, they're always after me.
So, do they send you out bad things?
Sometimes they have. The Democrats do, yeah.
And we talked last week or the week before about your wife who went to the hospital.
Right.
She it was a cancer. You showed me this beautiful card that was sent to you.
Yeah.
Beautiful card. I opened. I saw the card. It looked like it was $2, $3
card.
Okay.
Looked like a nice card.
And you opened it up, and it said what?
Well, it just said so that I heard you're sick to my wife. It was too. I hoped you'd die, but I guess next time.
Yeah, I saw that, and I don't like that. I also saw some emails. Don't do that. That's awful.
Yeah, but you know something?
That's awful.
I looked up.
And I cannot believe a sensible Democrat would do that.
Yes, I looked them all up. And, they're idiots because when they're not smart on the computer. These are illiterate liberals.
You're being nice.
They're
more than idiots.
No, but I'm saying every one of them.
No, anybody who does that, especially when
you,
it has to do with your wife.
There was a couple of them that were Bernie supporters because you can see who they support.
All right.
But 98% of them were all Clinton.
Believe that. It's hard to believe.
I showed you.
Look, I just told you that you were extremely generous by saying they're all idiots.
But I showed you who they were.
Well,
they were Democrats.
Then you let me know. I'll call their house.
Okay.
Are they running for anything? No, they're not running for anything.
No, they're not. They're idiots.
All right.
I wish they'd come face to face.
All right. So what other things are taking place across the state? I understand the Speaker of the House, Sean Jasper, is being bombarded with bad mail, bad people running against him.
Yeah. That's what I heard.
And it on and on.
There's like 17 people running for 11 seats in his district.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, they're determined to knock him out. Because of him, we got Medicaid expansion.
Yeah, and that's right. Ladies and gentlemen, we have Medicaid expansion. If we didn't, it was 3,330 from Nashua who would have no insurance. Thank you, Sean Jasper. Where does the insurance come from?
You make me laugh at what you
just
said.
Where does the insurance come from?
Well, they're private companies, but it's subsidized. Subsidized by the taxpayers.
Okay.
And 90%
of it. So what do they do if you don't have insurance?
So what's happened is 90% of it now, I believe it, I think it's down to 90, isn't it? It's being paid by the federal government. We pick up 10%. And then next year it go down again. Now, if you talk to people in your district like I do, the ones that do have it, they're going in debt just to use it. They got $10,000, $12,000 deductibles. They have to have you spend $10,000, $12,000 before they can use it.
So,
okay.
You kind of got it wrong.
Do
that's
I,
that's not what it's for. You got
no,
it wrong.
What's it for?
As usual.
Well, tell me
you
what,
got
tell me
it
what
a
it's for.
Wrong.
Tell me what that
so,
$10,000
all right, now,
is.
Well, hold on a second. You're saying this, the Medicaid expansion, mm-hmm. these people can't afford to get it.
No, no, they had insurance. A lot, many of them had insurance. They were paying
Where
for
do
their
they
own
have
insurance
it?
Through their jobs or through other stuff.
You know,
many of them are working
you
people.
You keep saying that.
They're all working people.
You have been saying this for 4 or 5 years.
They are
years.
Working people.
And
I already showed you.
That's not the truth.
I showed you.
That's not
you know
the some, truth.
I already showed
You're
you the numbers.
You're under the impression they're all working. They're
a
not
family,
all working.
A family of two, mom and dad, I'm not counting any children, could make up to over $68,000 a year and qualify for Medicaid expansion. Not Medicaid. Medicaid's different.
You just told me the deductibles are $5,000 to $9,000 or $12,000 or $10,000.
It is on some.
So,
of
what
the
type
insurance.
Of insurance is that?
It, some of the insurance that certain people that make over that or whatever they got.
All right. Okay.
On the regular insurance.
So,
apples and oranges.
So, ladies and gentlemen,
Medicaid expansion and ACA.
If you wouldn't have had Medicaid expansion in the city of Nashua, that would have been 3,300, I believe, who would have no insurance right this moment. So, guess what? Thank you, Sean Jasper, who happens to be a Republican.
And thank you to everyone else, to Sean Jasper, for redistributing everybody else's money, making people taking food off of many of our constituents' table because now they got to pay more.
Excuse
if
me.
The civilians,
didn't you just say the federal government is paying 90% of it?
Where do you think the federal government's getting the money from?
Excuse me.
Where's the
no,
federal government
no,
getting
no,
the
no.
money? Where is the federal government getting the money
from?
From
us.
Okay. Then what happens to the people that are paying
you know,
into insurance?
You know what I love about people like this? I mean, I love this
you
guy.
You hate the truth.
You
don't
want to know something what he
you
does.
Hate the
you
truth.
Don't want to listen to this. Guess what? If we give the federal government our money, we should get some of it back. This guy thinks, and a lot of people, oh, no, we don't want it back because, gee, it comes from us. Well, we want some of it back. We want it for the roads. We
you
want
know,
it
some,
for the insurance. This
know,
guy says no.
No. What they're doing is they're raising everyone else's premiums. Don't believe me. You all know that are paying it. You all get your insurance, your premiums. I don't know how many that I see
no,
what, that tell me their premiums
excuse,
are going
excuse
up.
Excuse me. Are you telling
he must live
me,
in a closet
excuse
somewhere.
Me, excuse me. Are you telling me the federal government has something to do with that?
No, no. Wait. Well, you're not listening to me. Medicare expansion and ACA. Okay, it all comes down to the same thing. Medicaid expansion is for people that pay under $78,000 or $68,000. I don't remember the numbers. ACA are for people there, okay, that want to go don't want Medicaid expansion, but can go into the exchange and the federal exchange and pick insurances there. Their deductibles and everything else are out of control. Their premiums are up high. They're paying higher premiums so the Medicaid expansion can work.
Well, you know that's.
Well, don't you understand?
No. Well, no.
You telling me I'm wrong?
Yeah, you are.
I
you
don't
are
think
really
so.
Wrong.
I don't think so.
But you want to know why? Look,
I don't think so.
Hold on a second. Look.
I don't think you have
look,
a clue.
You know something? Hold on a second. What committee are you in?
I'm on State and Federal Relations and Veterans Affairs.
All right, I'm in Commerce. Do you
okay.
know what Commerce is? Excuse me. Do you know what Commerce is?
Okay. Yeah, you're
banking
insurance.
Banking and insurance.
Okay.
So did, don't tell did, me about
okay.
insurance.
Did Medicaid expansion go to your committee?
No.
Okay, then I rest my case because they had no confidence.
Because I have no knowledge of it, but that's
right.
what I've done for
okay.
8 years.
But they didn't trust you.
You know
your
something,
speaker
you know
didn't
something,
trust
Al,
you.
You know what he's not telling you, and let's just get back to this. The Republicans made it illegal. Are you ready for this? Is that you?
I think so.
Okay, the Republicans made it illegal
I didn't know that was on.
To start to have an insurance exchange. Okay? Made it illegal. So an insurance company comes in.
I supported it.
Huh?
I supported making it legal.
Okay, an insurance company comes in, and guess what they do? They get rid of 10 hospitals, one is in Nashua, and they run it like
this. Tell
the
truth, Mr. Insurance
Know-It-All. And guess what happens?
Tell the truth.
People in Nashua lost jobs because of this, because of the Republicans.
Tell the truth.
Not doing the insurance exchange. So now it costs more money. And you may not have your own doctor or your own hospital. And it has nothing to do with Obamacare. It has something to do with the Republicans in the state of New Hampshire making it illegal to have an insurance exchange, which means
tell the truth.
As an insurance exchange,
tell the truth.
The people in Nashua would not have been taken advantage of. Shame on you.
You're not telling the truth on that there. First of all,
for God's sake, the
company Antrim there, when ACA came in, there was Exeter and a couple other hospitals out in that area in the south, and a few others were taking that insurance company to court over they were paying like 30 cents on the dollar or maybe less than that. There was issues there. It was that insurance company that knocked out the 10 hospitals that weren't doing business, okay, with them, because the other insurance companies that were doing business with them weren't in New Hampshire anymore. They couldn't do it ACA.
Excuse me.
Now,
so
under
what?
Medicaid
excuse me.
Expansion,
well, hold on a second. So
there's three insurance companies.
Hold on. This is the second largest city. Mm-hmm. We have St. Joe's.
We beat
we
this
have
over
Southern.
And over. You know, so we beat
and
this.
They got rid of one of our hospitals.
We beat this over and over and over. And you
can
just
we move it on? I'd like to talk about something local. Can we do that?
We are talking local.
We even talked about that criminal Trump.
Hey. Let's talk about local under the ACA. Let's talk about local under the ACA, how companies are going down to 30 hours a week, some companies, and how people are not.
That's awful.
You know what I mean?
That's
why?
Awful.
Because of the Affordable Care Act.
No.
Because if you
no.
got 50 or more.
No.
It's not because of that?
What's it because of
Know-It-All?
No, ladies and gentlemen.
What is it for?
Ladies and gentlemen. Businesses, and I'm really sorry to say this.
Why are they going under 30 hours?
Well, insurance is one reason.
Affordable car, Obamacare. That's why. Because if you're under 30
hours
a week,
you're not considered
full-time. So
if you have 40 hours, they must pay insurance.
They must pay insurance,
right. Must pay insurance to their employees.
And the insurance costs have gone up since the Affordable Care Act kicked in.
You know,
so the companies can't afford it anymore.
You know, that... There's, you know, what I like about you, and every single thing you say,
do you disagree
part
what I just
of
said?
It is the truth, and part
Tell
of
me
it
what
is
part
not
isn't.
The truth.
Tell me what part isn't.
Because
Tell me what part
this
isn't.
Was taking place before this happened.
It was?
Yes, it was.
You mean the 22,000?
That's exactly correct. And because I want to tell
me how
right.
it happened.
Wait a minute. That's a right to work, ladies and gentlemen. That's what we want here in New Hampshire. Boy, I'll tell you.
You know, some there you go. Change the subject. Go to right to
change
work.
Change the
you know
subject.
I mean? Yeah, because what was going on here in New Hampshire, people were paying for their own insurance.
You know.
We have Medicaid. We had Medicaid for low-income
you
people.
Know,
we
Al,
had children insurance.
I love how you... After you finally shown that you are completely wrong, we'll pick up that which is right and turn around and point at people like
me
and say, I don't know what's going on.
Let me ask you a question.
No, let me ask you a question. Let's get in. We got 20 minutes left. Let's get into the real stuff.
Okay.
You have your constitution on you?
I get it.
Let's see it.
No, I'm not wasting my time.
But you have it.
Because you don't even
have it, right?
Yeah, I have it.
Well, let's see. If we were in Russia today,
right. Yes.
We would not be able to have this program. But wait, Trump says Putin is a great leader who knows how to run his country. And by the way, I didn't say this. A Republican said this.
Okay.
So wasn't Hitler a nice guy?
Now, can I touch
Guess
on this?
What?
You know something? Ronald Reagan Ronald Reagan went after Russia, and then he worked with Russia and had the utmost respect for Gorbachev. And then when he met there and he said, Gorbachev, take down this wall. They became friends. They worked together. Why, and I believe in as a military, my military mind is Russia is a superpower like the United States. Why shouldn't we want to work with Russia and try to do trade? Why should we want to join forces with Russia to take out ISIS? Why are we so worried about Assad, okay, and then all of a sudden we got to do nation building again? Donald Trump is right.
Oh, wait a minute.
We've been doing nation building for too long.
I think, ladies and gentlemen, it has something to do with assassinating reporters, going to Crimea, taking over Crimea.
I understand
that. No.
If we had a strong president, that would have never happened.
Hold on a second. If you do not, and by the way,
we have a weak
by the way, he broke all international laws by doing that. It has nothing to do with
it. We have a weak president.
Compared to who?
Obama's a weak president.
Compared to who?
Oh, we're going to draw on the side.
Excuse me. Compared to who?
Obama said.
Are you telling me Putin?
You know something?
You like Putin better than Obama?
I just think Putin is getting over on Obama.
You're a military man. You know, how can you think this way?
If you look, do a Google search on strifing under years ago when Reagan was the president.
Why don't you say in this century? Why do you do this?
I don't, You know something?
All right, look, I got a great idea.
No. You know, I can't let you sit there and be, a 12 BS here.
All right.
This is supposed to be a show about fact, the truth, not BS.
Yeah, well, your man screwed up.
Ronald Reagan
with
Russia.
Will you stay to this period?
Why can't I finish it?
All right, okay. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Okay.
Yep.
Ronald Reagan, when Russia kept coming around our ships, locked and loaded on them, okay, he didn't play games. Russia backed off. Ronald Reagan told Gorbachev to bring down that wall. Under Bush, it came down. I was in the military when it came down. Ronald Reagan worked hand in hand with Russia, okay? We established a trade. We established other stuff with Russia. Obama is a weak, weak president. He told... I'm not done yet.
He said
to Assad, if you use chemicals as a line in the sand, he did nothing. Russia, Putin is more of a powerful leader, took advantage of our weakness, and went into us and helped in the Syria. You disagree with what I just said?
Anytime
you disagree,
a person
was I right?
says that a communist... leader is better than American president.
We have a
as a
saying,
soldier.
You know some? No, I'm not a soldier.
You, no, I'm not going to let you get away
I'm
with
a
this.
Marine, but I'll answer.
You're, no, wait a minute.
I'll answer.
No.
Obama is useless.
What?
In my
what?
Is that what you want to hear?
Oh yeah, right.
He's
that's
useless.
Right. Absolutely useless, ladies and gentlemen.
He weakened our country.
The day
he weakened our military.
850,000 people lost their jobs. Gee, what's our economy now?
Who was in charge
what
of the House?
Great?
Who was in charge of the House
Honest
and the Senate?
To God,
the
ladies
Democrats.
And gentlemen. Hey, guess what?
When the economy went down.
I just drove in here, and guess what they said? It was a sign. We are the transit system of Nashville. We need people to drive
you
buses.
You have no clue, Ken.
All right.
Ken, you have no clue. Right. The Democrats were running the House and the Senate under Bush's last 2 years. They controlled the purse strings, okay? With their regulations,
stop.
With their BS.
Oh, stop.
It's the truth.
Will you
it's the truth.
Please stop?
Why do you think right now we got record dollars coming in?
You know,
why do you think record dollars are coming into the
first
treasury?
First of all, this is an election year.
Why
and
are record dollars
really
coming into the treasury right now?
Don't.
Why?
Al.
Why?
You're a military
why?
Man. I'm on one subject, you're another. You're a military
yes.
man. How can you put up with
Because as
Trump.
A military
how
man,
can you?
As how can you put up with a liar, Benghazi? Benghazi
making,
on national security.
Making statements
how can you
Putin is stronger
you support Hillary,
than
right?
our president?
You support Hillary?
Excuse me.
Do you support Hillary?
Excuse me. No, I'm asking you
do
a
you
question.
You support Hillary?
Yeah, I do.
Okay,
I'm asking you a question now. You answer mine. You answer my question.
Your question's always stupid, but go ahead. I'll answer
a
your
military
question.
Man.
I'll
you
answer
know,
your question.
You know, ladies
I'll
and gentlemen,
question,
before the show,
did.
I
you're
usually
deaf.
Asks
no.
my friend.
No, you're deaf. I
what
answered your question.
Must take
Obama
place
is weak.
Before
Clinton's just as
you
weak.
Think Trump is an idiot.
What?
What has to happen?
He's right about Putin being stronger than Obama. Obama is
in
weak.
In what way?
In every way. I'll draw a line in the sand. If you use chemicals, Syria. What did Obama do about Kremlin?
Invading.
What did Obama do?
Invading another country.
What did Obama do to stop him? What did Obama do?
Guess what? You know why he has an 82% and Trump brings it up. I don't know why. 82% people like him over there. You want to know why? He runs at the place.
Ken, you're a typical liberal.
He's a.
You have no damn right.
Hey, look.
You have no damn clue.
Look, what did
Obama
do?
What did Obama do to stop the crime?
I am not going to let you.
What did Obama do? Answer me.
A Republican.
Answer me.
I'm not letting you do what Republicans do.
Answer me.
We were talking about.
Please answer me.
We were talking about Putin, and you changed the subject.
What did Obama do?
What did Obama do?
What did Obama do to Crimea, to Russia, when he went into Crimea? What did he do in Syria? What did he do with the buildup of ISIS in Iraq? What has he done?
Oh, no, wait a minute. Excuse me.
He's a weak son of a gun.
Trump said that Hillary and our presidents are what?
I can't deal with this shit anymore.
Are what?
I can't deal with this. No, I'm serious. I can't.
Oh, come on.
Because I'd rather debate somebody with knowledge. I'd rather debate somebody that understands tactics. I'd rather debate somebody that understands. When you say we're going to draw a line in the sand and you do nothing after they gas their people, well, that's weakness. If you say that we're going to stop Crimea, you know, Russia from going into Crimea, you've done nothing. Putin shit all over that president, our president. What don't you understand?
Okay.
Rules of engagement. My fellow veterans are getting killed because of rules of engagement.
So he's
you have no clue.
Stronger president.
He is a stronger
and a better president
than Obama.
Than Obama. So a communist president, as a soldier,
he's taken advantage.
Who is your commander in chief?
He's taken advantage of Obama.
You would rather take Biden
Putin. I never will. Never will. I said his leadership, his being forceful, making Obama look like a weak little chicken.
You don't understand. If we were in Russia, we couldn't do this show.
Under Ronald Reagan.
Don't you understand? You know, that's a strong man.
Under Ronald Reagan and George Bush, they would have never come close to our ships. Under Ronald Reagan and under Bush, that ship, that little Navy vessel that was captured, they'd have been locked and loaded. They would have all been guns at each other. It would have never happened. The command.
That's right. We should really shoot these things down.
No, what don't you
understand?
We
know they're playing games.
It's an act of war.
They know they're trying to push us because they know, the president knows, that as soon as it happens, they will stop war.
It's an act of war.
And blame it on us.
So right now, that's what they're doing. It's called COVID.
Is it illegal to fly 10 feet away from a plane?
Do you know what it's tactical strategic movements on probing is?
So what should you do?
Do you know what probing is?
Excuse me.
Do you know what probing is?
What should you do?
Do you know?
You would talk. Okay, what's probing?
Probing is when you take an aircraft or other areas and you're coming in as close as you can, okay? It's to see how far you can go. It's a matter of time a ship is going to be blown out of the water.
Okay.
Because we're not doing nothing.
Okay.
We're letting it go.
Okay.
They're probing our weaknesses. That's what they're doing.
Okay.
You don't get it. You don't understand.
So what you're saying is when that ship, or not the ship, the plane recently, they should have shot that plane down?
I'm saying they should have locked on them in general quarters. They should have locked on their weapons on them, I'm saying. I didn't say
that's
shoot.
That's all.
Because another aircraft, your radar, can pick up if a gun's locked in on you. You don't have to be shot, but if their radar's locked you in on that, you know, with a gun, they back off. But we're not doing that.
Are you sure?
Oh, here we
why
go
are you,
again.
Why
here
are you?
Here we go again.
No, but we
know. You don't think I know what I'm talking about?
No, but you make a really bizarre point.
Do you know what
general locked and loaded. So what do we do? Shoot?
No, nobody said shoot. You're
so
not listening to me.
All you do is you don't think they locked and loaded
with
on these?
Stuff.
You don't think they locked and loaded on these?
No.
Well, I'll tell you what, the plane wasn't a military
where
plane.
Where is the president coming out and standing his ground and say, Russia, enough is enough? If you come in so close, that's an act of war.
You know, I'll tell you
where
what.
Where is the president?
You know something. I'll tell you. I take it that you agree that we got to get rid of all these generals, right?
I think the ones that are working under Obama, you know, I'm glad you brought that up, okay? I'm glad you brought that up.
God,
you
thought
just
I was going
right
to be
in.
Able to move on.
There's a list of military leads.
Talk about something nice.
Since we're on the military, list of military elite purged and fired under Obama, compiled by General Paul Valley. General Paul Valley is one of the best generals, okay, along with General Mathis.
Is
and
he
others.
Retired?
He forced out. The generals that stood
well,
up.
Well, I don't like generals who get fired.
Generals that have stood up to Obama and other admirals have been relieved of duty. They've been told to stand down in Benghazi and relieve the duties. Now,
oh, that's a, you don't, no, don't let's okay. not get into Benghazi.
Here we go.
Again.
Don't get into that.
Benghazi again.
Here is the facts right here, put out by General Valley. Here is a list of our military elite who have been purged or fired under Obama, commanding general. Commanding general is fired. General John R. Allen, Major General Ralph Baker, Major General Michael Carey, Colonel James Christmas.
What does Christmas do?
He was the commander of the 22nd Marine Expeditionary Unit.
And why was he fired?
Because he spoke out. They spoke what out against the strategies Obama's people wanted him to use.
No, isn't it the generals who make up the people and at the White House, the generals, you know? Aren't they the ones?
You know something, Ken? I didn't want to talk this here. I brought you in the proof. This is put out by General Valley.
All right.
Okay, what's going on?
Al.
You'll never accept the facts.
No, I won't accept
You'll never accept
no,
the
no,
facts.
No, I'll tell you what. Look, if you really honestly believe that your person has done good for the United States recently, I think you're mistaken. I really do, Al. And I'm wondering.
No, but that's your opinion.
When
you lack military knowledge, I understand.
That a communist president
is more
better
than our own
than
president.
Our president.
No, I didn't say better. He's more powerful than our own president is weak.
Well, you know, I'll tell you what. We can be more powerful.
Look at this here. This is put out by General Valley. Here's the proof right here.
All right.
Look at all these names that have been released for standing up.
We started with Trump wants to fire all these generals. How many does he want to fire?
General Obama kept the yes people.
He's not General Obama.
I mean, General Obama kept the yes generals. He kept the politicians that agree and just go along along.
So a lot of the retired people are against.
The voiceful generals, the ones that believe that our strategy against ISIS, our strategy against Syria, our strategy against Russia is crippling our military. Look at all the aircraft that are crashing.
Don't make statements like that. Look at all the aircraft because we don't have.
Don't make mistakes.
Look at the last few months. Here we go.
Do a Google search and look at the lack of airtime that our pilots are getting because of lack of money. Sequestration, what it did under Obama.
Gee, I wonder where the money was taken away from.
It went to the refugees.
My God.
It went to the refugee program.
The Republicans cut the bill for the military.
Now they want to build it up. Because Obama threatened to shut down the government.
Obama threatened to shut down the government.
Because he threatened to veto.
You're the guys who shut the government down.
No, he threatened to veto.
I love this, ladies and gentlemen. No. I love it. They shut the government down, and now it's Obama. We got six minutes and 2 seconds, 1 second. How's your wife?
My wife is doing great.
She had an operation, very serious.
Now, I have to admit, the last few shows that I've done with this man, my blood pressure has gone up high, and I get pains in my chest.
Okay?
Just sitting here, you know what I mean, going back and forth, because I feel that I am wasting my time and energy because I track on state and federal. I track facts. I'm in groups of military with colonels, generals on the groups that we have that are on Facebook that are retirees. We understand we keep up with the Marine Corps University on what's going on with the different groups, with the Kurds and different what's happening in Syria with the ISIS, on how they grew and everything else. But I can't keep sitting here and argue over stuff that I know that I have to keep trying to prove.
Your man
It has nothing to do with it. You Democrats,
and you've done some pretty dumb
it.
Things also
You Democrats
recently.
Don't get it on the weakening of our country.
No.
Of our military, on the degrading of our military, on
turning
them into a social.
I've been trying for a half an hour.
I just get so aggravated, and I just can't deal with this. I'm being honest.
Then let's not talk about things like that. Let's talk
about
nice things.
Like what?
Well,
like what? I at least want you to be honest.
What is taking? All right. Do you think? Let's talk about. We're both representatives. We're both running again. Let's talk a little bit about that. Are you under the impression the Republicans are going to take the House?
Yes.
Why?
Because I believe they're the people there that I've been dealing with, Democrats and Republicans that I see around the state and in my district there. They're so disgusted. They can't afford to be taxed anymore. They can't afford insurance anymore.
Nobody taxes. Nobody wants a tax.
Your property tax is going up. Your insurance,
excuse me, ladies and gentlemen,
if it's
the Republicans who run the House and you blaming a Democratic governor,
you know,
please.
In my town, we're fortunate because our property taxes have gone down the last 2 or 3 years.
Yeah.
You never hear that. You never, ever hear that. In the town of Londonderry, because we have a guy who ran for governor, Kevin Smith, who is our town manager now, in the last 3 years, our property taxes have gone down.
Excuse me.
Okay.
Why?
Now, why? Because they cut the spending. And they
No.
They cut spending.
I'll bet you they didn't cut the spending.
Yeah, they did.
No.
They cut the spending.
You read a whole thing this afternoon.
These are businesses that are coming in.
Before, yeah, that's correct.
Right.
Because you're right next to the airport.
What,
part of it's next to... In London area is what? Is it the second largest plot of land?
What we did, we became a business-friendly town. We put out to our town, and we hired people to redo our website to grab businesses to come into New Hampshire in our industrial areas. We've done the manager has done the
it's
right thing.
It's because of the airport.
No, the
airport has
you know, you got an airport, too, in Concord. I mean, in here in
Nashville. No, it's
in
not
Nashua.
Like that. We,
but
we
you got a small
we
airport.
Cannot land
but you got a small
airport.
So maybe Nashua should invest
right,
in it.
Ladies,
like Worcester did.
I'm trying. So, okay. So
Worcester invested
right,
in area field.
Let's go through a little
Do you know
more.
Worcester had a
You're
small
airport.
You're
under the impression the Republicans are going to take it.
Yes, I am.
Okay.
Yes.
Who will be running for the Speaker of the House?
I don't know. We'll cross that bridge when it comes.
I heard...
You know, we'll
Laurie Sanborn?
I don't know. I don't know. I
you don't know? You haven't heard?
I've been paying attention. Who's running on the Democrats?
Shurtleff.
Who else? I heard you got there's an issue going on right now with the Democrats. Who else?
No, I don't know.
Yeah, you got it.
Who is
it? I'll leave it at that. If you don't know what goes on in your Democrat party,
if I don't
I'll
know, he doesn't
yeah,
know.
Yeah, I do.
Gee. Well, you know what Bert told me?
There are people right now that said they can't support.
Bert, by the way, is running.
No, I don't think so. But
oh, yeah. And you know what Bert said?
What?
Bert. And he would do this. He's
a great guy,
he's
John
funny.
Bert.
He's coming here, by the way. We're gonna you know. Bert said that what he would do is if Democrats won, they would nominate me to be Speaker.
They'd nominate you?
To be Speaker. All I'd have to do is get 40, 50 people. I don't
you'll
want
never,
that.
But no, you'll never get it.
He's funny. So okay,
never,
how can people get in touch
get
with
it.
You?
Well... Very simple. I'm on Facebook. I'm on LinkedIn. I'm on Twitter. I have a website, www.albaldessaro.com. Look at the factual stuff that I post out there. I post stuff up there which so people can trust but verify on what I say. And I put sites out there, okay, URLs where I get my information from, just like I brought in the list from General Valley here, okay, which he won't believe. So...
Okay, come on.
You can reach
any
me.
Way, can they, come
you can
on.
Call me, 425-6997. Stop by my house, 41 Hall Road in Londonderry. Let's talk.
Anybody ever stop by?
Yeah, I've had people stop by, yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, I've had people, look, quite a few. You'd be surprised the people I've held, even in your own district here in Nashua in a court case.
Some people do,
You'd
that's right.
Surprised.
And my name is Ken Gidge, and I am running for state representative. So isn't my friend right here. We are friends. We do shake hands. We do riled up. Okay.
And he gets my blood pressure.
No,
going.
And I really want to talk a little bit about your wife because your wife is a sweetheart.
Mm-hmm. She's doing
she
good.
Had a cancer.
Yep, she's
it's
cancer-free.
Cared for.
Yep.
I couldn't be happier. She's
mm-hmm.
such a sweetheart and well, obviously far
well,
better
you.
For you. You know, you...
Well, I'll be the first one to say I married up. I married an angel.
Married up.
I did. I'm not bashful
to
say that.
Too. So we will see you next
Lee's
week.
Lee's a great lady.
All right.
Yeah.
You
I wish she would do the show.
All right. You can get me at GidgeWorld.com. I'm on LinkedIn. I'm on them all. Facebook
at least
and everything.
Lee will tell the truth.
Yeah, Lee tells the truth. All right.
You
let
do
me
get
tell
my
you.
Blood pressure
She's
going.
She's so mad. She was, what do you mean I got your blood pressure? Of course I get your blood pressure. That's what you do.
Yeah, I understand.
That's what we're supposed to do.
But at least have the facts.
Oh, for God's sakes. What do you mean the facts?
Right there.
Oh, for God. No. We got
look,
five.
Right here.
Seconds.
Right
don't
there.
Don't Trump.
Right there.
Trump my foot.
We got that?
Bye.
Veterans Thank for you. Trump.
The preceding program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.